Good morning, everybody. I am Dr. Kannucharana Patro, Neuroradiation Oncologist. Today, I am going to talk about decision making in brain tumors. Under this category, we will discuss today about the vestibular schwannoma. Acoustic neuroma or vestibular schwannoma is a benign tumor arising from the Schwann cells in the nerve sheath covering the vestibular cochlear nerve. You can see in the internal acoustic matters, this growth and compressing the brain here. So if you see, it is the acoustic neuroma is not a now it is a old name, because most of the tumors arising in the vestibular part of the vestibular cochlear nerve, superior and inferior vestibular nerve. So this is the facial nerve here, this is the cochlear nerve, and the mostly arising from the superior and inferior vestibular nerve. So if you see the acoustic neuroma here, this is the vestibular schwannoma. You can see this at the tumor arising from the internal acoustic meatus. It is the pons, brainstem pons. This is the fourth ventricle. This is the cerebellum. This is a confluence of sinuses. This is occipital lobe. This is the temporal lobe. So if the patient presents mostly with sign symptoms, it depends upon the size of the tumor. Mostly, if it is intracranial, they will have a hearing loss, tinnitus, vertigo. If it is a cisternal component, worsening the hearing loss, vertigo diminishes and disequilibrium increases. If it is a brainstem compression, it is a midfacial or corneal hypesthesia, occipital headache and ataxia. Hydrocephalic, if patient slowly grows and obstructing the CSF path, patient may be trigeminal dysfunction, gait deterioration, retained raised ICT, lower cranial dysfunction and death due to tonsillar herniation. But these are the very symptoms are very rare. So based on the growth, the Coos grading system is mostly appreciated. In grade 1, intracranial tumor, grade 2, into the cisterna but not reaching the brainstem, grade 3, reaching the brainstem surface, and grade 4, deforming the brainstem surface and shifting to the fourth ventricle. So you can see here, stage 1, that is the intracranial, stage 2, it cisternal component, stage 3, it is touching the brainstem, and stage 4, deforming in brainstem and obstructing the CSF flow. So in this, after this gross discussion, what are the modes of treatment? Remember, observation is one of the mode of the treatment. You can go for stereotactic radiosurgery or stereotactic radiotherapy. You can go for the surgery. But these things is deciding by age, growth pattern, stage, symptoms, and residual. So, if you are planning for an observation, see for few things. If tumors are less than 15 mm, intracranial vestibular schwannoma without any tinnitus, elderly person with significant comorbidities, observation with the radiological surveillance and audiometry you have to do. Nearly 50% experience no growth or negative growth during observation. Average tumor growth is around roughly 1.9 mm per year, and maximum tumor growth is seen in first year. Surveillance during observation. If you are put a patient on a surveillance observation, you have to do active surveillance. You have to do an MRI 6 months after first imaging. First imaging should be done after 6 months, then yearly MRI 5 years. For 5 years, then every alternate year for next 4 years, for minimum surveillance 10 years. So minimum surveillance period is 10 years. You have to do any contrast MRI. You have to do you have to do 6 months, 6 months, then every year till 5 years, then every 2 years for next year, 4 years. So active surveillance or minimum surveillance is for the 10 years. Remember, when you are putting the patient in the observation, you should predicting the factors for repeat growth. So if there is these are the predicting factor, large tumor with a diagnosis, it may grow for repeat growth. Tinnitus increase at diagnosis, if patient presenting with tinnitus, there is a high chance of threefold increasing of the tinnitus. Intracranial tumors growing significantly at lesser than CP angle tumors, extramedial tumors, and compared to solid lesion, cystic lesions having greater growth rate. So when you are going for the observation, see these criteria, whether if they are not fitting well, please consider for any form of treatment. When we should go for surgery, if there is a large tumors, Coos grade 4, mass effect, brainstem or patient having a hydrocephalus, cystic lesions, surgery is considered in view of rapid and dramatic growth pattern of lesion. So cystic lesion is a dramatic pattern of growth. So consider cystic lesions, large tumors and mass effect, the lesions causing mass effect. So when you should go for the radiotherapy in the form of stereotactic radiosurgery or stereotactic radiotherapy, tumors up to 3 cm are treated with highly conformal radiotherapy. Residual or recurrent lesions post surgery, progressive lesion on observation. So these three things we have to go for the radiotherapy. Tumors up to 3 cm is treated with highly conformal technology, maybe SRS and SRT. Residual or recurrent lesion post surgery or progressive lesion on observation. Let's say let's study some algorithms. If there is a small vestibular schwannoma, if you do the pre-treatment hearing, I mean age is less than that is preserved hearing and age is less than 70, you can go for the surgery. If it is more than 70, wait and watch and surveillance. If tumor grows, you can go for stereotactic radiosurgery or surgery, but there is no tumor growth, wait and watch. If treat hearing is not preserved, age less than 70, you can go for radiosurgery and surgery. More than 70, you can wait and watch again. But if there is a tumor growth on observation, you should go for surgery and radiosurgery. If there is no tumor growth, you can wait and watch. Another algorithm here I am putting, if there is intracanalicular tumor, intracanalicular small tumors less than 1.5 cm, normal serviceable hearing, serial imaging, no growth, continue. If there is a non or serviceable hearing, if there you are thinking no or non serviceable hearing, if there is a growth, go for a stereotactic radiosurgery. And medium sized tumors, if there is a normal hearing, you can less than 1.5 cm, you can go for serial MRI. If there is a growth, again you have to think of the microsurgery or stereotactic radiotherapy. If any is non-serviceable hearing, you can have again you can go for the stereotactic radiotherapy or microsurgery is an option. For large tumor, definitely you have to go for microsurgery. If normal hearing, you can go for rectal sigmoid approach and no hearing, non-serviceable hearing, translabithan approach, and post you have to do the post intervention MRI regularly. Let's go for another algorithm. Tumor size depends on the tumor size and brainstem compression. Two factors will decide. If there is intracanalicular tumor, age and health more than 75 years, you have to do observation, documented growth. If it is growth, you go for radiosurgery. If less than 75 years, observation. Again, it is if you growth, so go radiosurgery and microsurgery. Less than 30 cm, no brainstem compression. Review the treatments, goals and patient's choice, microsurgery, if there is a residual, again go for radiosurgery or you can go for direct radiosurgery. If there is a lesion is more than 3 cm, symptomatic compression, microsurgery, do radiosurgery, do microsurgery. If there is residual, go for radiosurgery. If there is complete dissection, you can go for the observation. Again, if there is a documented growth, you can go for the microsurgery and radiosurgery. Extracanular, another algorithm, if there is extracanular vestibular schwannoma, symptomatic, more than 2.5 cm, less than 2.5 cm. If there is a young, go for the microsurgery. Elderly comorbidities, you can go for radiosurgery. Patient is asymptomatic, young. Young, go for microsurgery, and asymptomatic, go for elderly person, observation, growth and symptomatic, less than 3 cm, more than 3 cm, go for microsurgery, and needed, you can go for shunt. So, radiosurgery, less than 3 cm, microsurgery, more than 3 cm, and need of shunt as per need. Management of algorithm for acoustic tumor, another another algorithm. You can see here, this is the intracanalicular tumor, size less than 1.5 centimeter, no tinnitus and less no symptoms. You can put an observation, MRI after 6 months, no growth, and you have to go for the regular surveillance and MRI as I told before. But if there is a less than more than 1.5 centimeter and less than 1.5 centimeter with tinnitus and symptomatic, you can see the growth pattern more than 2.5 mm per year. You can go for radiotherapy, there is less than 3 cm, go for stereotactic radiosurgery. You can go for single flexion around 10 to 13 gray with 50% isotolerance line prescription. Or you can go for conformal stereotactic radiotherapy around 54 to 57, 50 gray. And you can go for hypofraction radiotherapy when there is a trigeminal pain or slightly larger lesion around 5 fraction with 20 to 5 gray. Surgery, you should go for the symptomatic patients, and large tumors, you can go for the various surgeries as per the location and approach. And if there is some residual, you can go for the radiation as per the requirement. Thank you. But conclusion, you can observe the patient if there is asymptomatic or small growth. You can go for the radiation if there is residual, old age, no brainstem compression, less than 3 cm, non-cystic lesion. Surgery, you have to go for a symptomatic brainstem compression, cystic lesion, and there is a rapid growth. So this is the conclusion here. Tritate and analysis your the patient's symptoms, imaging findings, growth pattern, and all these things, course grading, and take decision accordingly. Give the option to the patients also when there is two options are required, and that is the all about the treatment of vestibular schwannoma, and hope you understand all these things. Thank you very much. I pray for the patients who are suffering with this vestibular schwannoma with love and care. I pray. Thank you very much. If you like, you can comment and share and subscribe my channel, Dr. Kanu Channapatro. Thank you very much.